That was the hairiest fight I've ever been in, and I've been in more than a few. I don't know about this Dragonborn business, but I'm sure glad you're with us. You better get back to White.
By Ismir, you did it! You killed the dragon.
It's no fun getting pushed
already
around.
Been
all
told
the time.
You're not allowed. Turn around and go back the way you came.
Do you get to the Cloud District very often? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you don't.
What's the matter? You can't stand the sight of a strong Nord woman?
Come to chat with an old woman, hmm? Do your good deed for the day.
Who is both man and divine! Trust in me, my friend.
Good. You're finally here. The Jarl's been waiting for you.
You heard the summons. What else could it mean?
The Greybeards.
We were just talking about you. My brother needs a word with you.
So what happened at the watchtower? Was the dragon there? I knew I could count on Irileth. But there must be more to it than that. Dragonborn? What do you know about the Dragonborn? So it's true. The Greybeards really were summoning you. Masters of the Way of the Voice. They live in seclusion, high on the slopes of the Throat of the World. The Dragonborn is said to be uniquely gifted in the Voice. The ability to focus your vital essence into a thoom, or shout. If you really are Dragonborn, they can teach you how to use your gift.
Didn't you hear the thundering sound as you returned to Whiterun? That was the voice of the Greybeards, summoning you to High Hrothgar. This hasn't happened in centuries, at least. Not since Tiber Septim himself was summoned when he was still Talos of Atmora.
Rungar, calm yourself. What does any of this Nord nonsense have to do with our friend here? Capable as he may be, I don't see any signs of him being this, what, Dragonborn.
Nord nonsense? Why, you puffed up ignorant. These are our sacred traditions that go back to the founding of the First Empire.
Rungar, don't be so hard on Avenichi.
I meant no disrespect, of course. It's just that... what do these Greybeards want with him?
That's the Greybeard's business, not ours. Whatever happened when you killed that dragon, it revealed something in you, and the Greybeards heard it. If they think you're Dragonborn, who are we to argue? You'd better get up to High Hrothgar immediately. There is no refusing the summons of the Greybeards. It's a tremendous honor. I envy you, you know, to climb the 7,000 steps again. I made the pilgrimage once. Did you know that? High Hrothgar is a very peaceful place. Very disconnected from the troubles of this world. I wonder that the Greybeards even notice what's going on down here. They haven't seemed to care before. No matter. Go to High Hrothgar. Learn what the Greybeards can teach you.
You've done a great service for me and my city, Dragonborn.
By my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of Whiterun. It's the greatest honor that's within my power to grant. I assign you Lydia as a personal housecarl, and this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble, now would we? We are honored to have you as Thane of our city, Dragonborn. Back to business, Proventus. We still have a city to defend.
Yes, my lord.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your housecarl. It's an honor to serve you. The Jarl has recognized you as a person of great importance in the Hold. A hero. The title of Thane is an honor, a gift for your service. Guards will know to look the other way if you tell them who you are. Farewell.
There's been talk amongst the guards that you are Dragonborn, but such a thing, surely that's not possible.
Ripe fruit and fresh vegetables for sale, straight from the fields and orchards of Whiterun to your table.
I work with my mother, sell fruits and vegetables. It's fun most days, but hard.
You there. We're looking for someone in Whiterun. We'll pay good money for information.
If you locate her, find us in Rorikstead.
gods gave you two hands, and you used them both for your weapon. I can respect that.
Thank you. Maik wishes you well.
Hail, friend. It's good to see another merry soul enjoying this fine day. Ah, but you look tired. Come, share a bottle of hunting brew mead with me. Cheers, my friend. May your adventures find you fame and fortune.
Yeah.
Greybeards have summoned the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. Such a thing has not happened for hundreds of years.
On your way up the 7,000 steps again, Clement?
Not today. I'm just not ready.
Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar. Thank you.
So, a Dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age. We will see if you truly have the gift. Show us, Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice. Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngeir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here? We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you. You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say. You have shown that you are dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro. Shout to strike the targets as they appear. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn. We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori. see how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
Wuld.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thum. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of Wuld. Master Hrothgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori?
X!
Wolf!
Okay.
Now it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes. Quick mastery of a new thum is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself? No, indeed not. But beware that your skill does not outstrip your wisdom. You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. Dragons have the inborn ability to learn and project their voice. Dragons also are able to absorb the power of their slain brethren. A few mortals are born with similar abilities. Whether a gift or a curse has been a matter of debate down through the centuries. What you have already learned in a few days took even the most gifted of us years to achieve. Some believe that Dragonborn are sent into the world by the gods at times of great need. We will speak more of that later, when you are ready. Sky? Got you.